Children, in this class we are going to learn about subject and predicate. Sentence is divided into two parts. You can see sentence can be divided into two parts, subject and predicate. The part of sentence which tells us who or what the sentence is about is the subject. In every sentence, we are talking about someone or something, and about whom we are talking or about what we are talking is the subject, and rest of the part is predicate. Like the part of sentence which tells us something about the subject is the predicate. For example, the tiger lives in the jungle. The tiger is a subject because in this sentence we are talking about the tiger. Who lives in a jungle? The tiger lives in the jungle. So the tiger is a subject and rest other part, that is lives in the jungle, is predicate. Subject word can be proper noun, common noun or pronoun. This subject word, it can be proper noun. For example, Amit likes to eat chocolate. Here Amit is a proper noun, it is a subject. Then it can be also common noun, like in this example you can see the tiger. Tiger is a common noun because here I have not written any particular name. So it is a common noun. Subject word is pronoun. For example, he is a good boy. Here he is a pronoun and he is a subject. So you must remember that subject word can be proper noun, common noun or pronoun. The predicate can be a single word also. For example, dogs bark. Who barks? So dogs bark. Dogs is a subject here and bark is predicate. Birds fly. Who flies? Birds fly. So bird here is a subject and fly is verb. So predicate can be of single word also. Bark, fly. And when you will find like this predicate with a single word, then it will always be a verb. Bark is verb, fly is also verb. Next point, in some sentences the subject does not come at the beginning. So in some sentences we will find that subject is not coming at the beginning. For example, down rolled the stones. What rolled down? The stones. So the stone is a subject which is at the end of the sentence and down rolled is a predicate. So a subject is not always at the beginning of the sentence. You may also find it at the end of the sentence. Next point is, in imperative sentences the subject is not mentioned. In imperative sentences, generally in sentences where command is given, like you can see study seriously, this is a command. So in this sentence subject is not mentioned. Subject is there, you is the subject here, but it is not mentioned. So if you will get this type of sentences, then you will write it as predicate. Study seriously is a predicate. There is no subject. Go to sleep. This is also predicate. Here subject is there, which is you, but it is not mentioned. So you will write that subject is not mentioned and go to sleep is a predicate. Next point, in exclamatory sentences the subject can be placed towards the end. In exclamatory sentences also we can find subject at the end. For example, what a beautiful rose. Rose is the subject which is placed at the end of the sentence. In interrogative sentences, the subject does not come at the beginning. For example, do you believe him? This is an interrogative sentence. And you is the subject, which is in between helping verb and main verb. So children, for doing any exercise on subject and predicate, you must remember all this point. First point is, the subject word can be a proper noun, common noun or pronoun. Second, always the subject does not come at the beginning. Third, in imperative sentences, the subject is not mentioned. Fourth, in exclamatory sentences, the subject can be placed toward the end. And fifth, in interrogative sentences, subject comes between the helping and main verb. I hope you have understood this lesson properly, and also you can do exercises on subject and predicate easily if you remember all this point. Thank you.